Welcome to the film Footsteps of Our Founders, where we will be looking at some London locations connected with the founding of Girl Guiding. And we'll also see a lot of iconic London sites as well. To create the feeling that we're journeying between various sites during these travel-free times, we will be virtually taking various double-decker buses. And lucky for us, we always somehow manage to get the front seat on the top. So I'm Catherine, and I'll be your guide. And come along with me now, we'll have a look. So many people are familiar with the name Julia Gordon Low and the fact that she was friends with and inspired by Lord Baden Powell to establish the Girl Scouts of the USA in 1912. But maybe many people don't realize that she actually spent a lot of time in the UK and in London specifically, and in this area of London. So where are we exactly? We're in Mayfair here, just off Grosvenor Square, which is the centerpiece of the Duke of Grosvenor's holdings in the area. He is the Duke of Westminster. Grosvenor is his family name. But first, some background.
Julia Gordon Low, known to her family as Daisy, was American, but after her marriage to William McKay Low, lived for part of the year in Warwickshire, England, as well as in Savannah, Georgia. Unfortunately, their marriage was not a happy one, and they were in the process of divorcing when her husband died in 1905. And Daisy was living here at number 40 when in May 1911, she met Robert Baden Powell and learned about the concept of scouting as fun with a purpose. Daisy immediately and wholeheartedly devoted her energies to the Girl Guiding movement, initially by forming several new troops and holding various leadership roles, and later to promoting international guiding and furthering cooperation between individual nations' guiding programs.
So we're here in Grosvenor Street because right behind me is the plot where the house that Julia Gordon Low bought in 1903 was originally. So she bought number 40 Grosvenor Street, and later on even bought number 39 in order to rent out for extra income. And it was not only Girl Scout matters and seeking advice from Baden Powell that brought her back to London, but also matters relating to these two properties here. So we're here in Grosvenor Square, which is the second largest square in London, and there's been an American presence here since John Adams arrived in 1785 to establish the first mission to the court of St. James. There's a lot of memorials and statues, connections with the Americans here, including a statue of Franklin Delano Roosevelt. There's also a memorial to the American Eagle Squadron that fought in World War II, suffered heavy casualties. And there's also a memorial to the British victims of 9/11. And also just on the square here, on the one side, is a building that replaced where Julia Gordon Low's home was. It became then the U.S. Embassy from 1938 to 1960. And after that, it was the Canadian Embassy. It's now being rebuilt to be luxury apartments. And on the opposite side of the square, we have the building that was the American Embassy from 1960 up until just fairly recently in 2018. And interestingly, it was the only American embassy in the world at that time where the government did not own the freehold on the property of that building. So everywhere else they always own the land under the building, but here they did not. So what had happened was they approached the Duke of Westminster and asked to buy the freehold, and apparently he supposedly said, well, if you give me back my property that was confiscated during the American Revolution, then I will sell you the freehold. And of course they didn't want to do that. What was the property, you might ask? Supposedly most of the state of Virginia. So at any rate, they didn't get the freehold. And but on the new building where the embassy has moved to, down in Nine Elms in the southwest of London, they do have the freehold on that new building. They had to build a new embassy because the old one was no longer in compliance with the security standards put out by the State Department.